What up? That's stupid. It's the Trooper. Yo, today is Friday. It's 1:18 p.m. and I got up at 12:30. I know I want to get up at 12. 12:30 is not that bad though.
Windmaster, yeah?
I got it from the Dollar Shave Club shits. All right, what are we forgetting? Nothing? Got the phone, got the keys, got the steak, got the charger, maybe shoes? Should I put shoes? Yeah. We're gonna wear shoes today. It's too cold to go without shoes. Too cold. Like my blood. What?
When it comes to coffee, I mean, I love it all year long. I love coffee in the summer, spring, winter, and fall. But when it starts to get cold outside, it becomes something a little more special. You know what I'm saying? Just a little more like warming, right? And so I'm gonna start today in honor of my love for coffee. I'm gonna start today with coffee. I know what you think, a trooper. How is that any different from any other day? It's not. It's not different from any other day. It's the same shit every day. Yo, my new phone is supposed to come today, but I won't be here to get it. They have a really cool system here at the apartment complex. There's these lockers by the pool, and so FedEx or whoever, they bring the shit and they lock the shit in a box, and so you get an email with a code and you use the code and then one of the boxes goes boop, pops open and you get your package out. Yo, get your package out. No, see what I did? No. Okay, so anyway, that's gross. Listen, so yeah, I've had this Samsung Galaxy S5 for over 2 years now, and it's starting to show its age a little bit, slowing down just ever so slightly. And I think the Galaxy S7 is in order. And yo, speaking of that, I mean, obviously it's not the Galaxy that's doing this, but the Samsung Note, whichever one it is that's just spontaneously catching on fire and exploding or whatever, the FAA banned that shit from airplanes. You can't have that particular phone on an airplane. So they made that announcement. I already saw it on the internet, but they made that announcement on the plane right before we took off. I am almost sure that the Chinese lady, I think she was Chinese, on my right in one of them planes, I think she had that phone. I think she had it. And she was just like, fuck that, I'm not giving up my phone. She didn't say it, but I swear I think she had that phone. Because I was like looking over there at it, she was using it, and I was like, looking at that phone, I was like, what if this shit blows up? Let's turn right here. Fuck, I'm going the wrong damn... I don't like this Starbucks. I don't want to go to this Starbucks. It's too late now. Fuck it, I'm here. Hey, man. Let's go in here and get this coffee. It was like a damn premonition. I knew I shouldn't go to this Starbucks. I don't like their attitude towards my sandwich. She threw it on the counter. I don't like that. There's something oddly good about drinking hot coffee after eating something a little bit spicy. Have you ever noticed that? I don't know what it is, but I had a chorizo and egg sandwich from Starbucks, and it is a little bit spicy. All right, changing lanes with the knee turn here. All right, got it.
Thank you for calling them Jim Jim Pugger.
Can you put Tim W on 1-2?
BMW.
Yep.
Seven.
Thank you.
Yeah. The way I felt in the shower earlier, I kind of felt like my body was expecting to go to the gym today. It seemed like it was like, all right, let's go. I know we're going because it's every other day. But yo, this 100 hours challenge, man, I gotta get these hours in, you know? So today is the flush card promotion. So if you make a flush in each of the suits before midnight tonight, you get $500. I think that's a lot tougher to hit than the football parlay, but you do have a lot longer. It's not gonna be easy. I'm not going for that, but if I happen to get it, I get it. But there will be people chasing that shit hard. So, something to keep in mind for the day. So whenever things are going well at the table, it's a lot easier to play longer hours. I've only been here for like 3 and I'm super frustrated, and it's making me wanna like call it a day and try to catch up later, but I don't think that's the right thing to do, so I'm just gonna take a walk for a minute. Being that the game is good, I mean, I shouldn't be frustrated. I keep telling myself to not be frustrated, but for some reason I am. A lot of people would be down over 1,000 right now. I'm down about 400. But there's, most people would have never folded the kings I had earlier, but it was extremely clear why the guy check raised on a jack 3-3. Basically though, the guy on my right raised to 7 and I re-raised to 25, and the guy on my left called 25 with pocket 10s, and the small blind called, and the guy on my right called. And the flop was jack 3-3 with 2 diamonds, and it went check, check to me, I bet 50 into 100. And the guy on my left called the 50. The guy on my left, I mean, I didn't know he had 10s at the time, he told me later, but there's no way he has a 3, no way. There's a chance he's on a flush draw, but because it was jack 3-3 with 2 diamonds. So the small blind check raises to 150. I know he has a 3. It's probably ace 3. And I think that he thinks that the guy on my left is possibly on a flush draw, because everyone is aware that everyone is chasing flushes. I think if the guy on my left folded his pocket 10s, the guy in the small blind would have probably just called my 50 and tried to get more money out of it. But either way, I folded the kings. I could have lost another $250 in that hand. I guess the point is, I could be down a lot more. Like, the deck is really fucking smacking me in the face. I took this walk and got a coffee to try to talk myself into staying and putting in the hours tonight. By the way, I have just over 31 hours before today started. So I'm a couple hours ahead of where I thought I was. Probably because the dealers are sometimes lazy about putting you in lobby when you get up and go to the restroom. It's actually already happened twice today. I come back after missing the blind even, and the thing is not flashing. So I know that I was left in. Here's the thing. There are things that are more important than the 100 hour challenge. Playing well is extremely more important than completing any challenge. 100 bad hours is worthless. 100 good hours is very valuable. So I guess I'm just talking my way through it right now, trying to decide what to do. You can't just quit and run every time things aren't going good, but you can sometimes. Sometimes it's the right thing to do. All right, so this is the way it is. I've been here for 4 hours. I just quit the game because I am not playing good hours right now. I'm not anywhere near my A game. And so my mind is just not in it. So it is way less profitable to sit there right now. But here's the reality. There's gonna be plenty of time for me to make up any hours I lost by getting up from the game right now. If it gets late in the challenge, what the fuck, that's loud. If it gets late in the challenge and I need the hours and I'm having a day like today, I'll sit there, you know what I mean? But the best part, and it has been the worst part, but the best part of doing what I'm doing is that I get to choose when I do it. I get to choose when I put my hours in. So I just sat there for about an hour since I last spoke to you. And I actually came back a little bit because I was down a little over 400. I lost 344. And I tried, I really did try. The players that were making the game good left the game. The entire table changed. And I don't know, I guess that just added to my dismay with the whole situation right now. So, believe it or not, I actually have other work that I can do right now at the moment, which is what I'm coming out here to do. My mind is just not in the game. And sometimes when my mind is not in the game and it's wandering off to other places, it's difficult for me to get my mind in the game. Now here's the thing. I could just sit there and nut pedal for hours and hours. But rather than just sit there and not even focus on the game and just play when I have a monster hand or just play cards, I mean, if I have a choice to sit there and do that now or to play my A game tomorrow, it's way better for me to play my A game tomorrow. I would rather take a break right now, decompress from poker for a few hours, if not for the rest of the night, and then get back in there, because if I'm gonna do 100 hours, it will be best to do 100 of my best hours. So the goal is not just to get 100 hours on the clock, it's to play poker and win while getting 100 hours on the clock. Check out this big ass Christmas ball. No? Big ass Christmas ball. I find myself standing here staring aimlessly at the Starbucks sign, considering getting a coffee and just chilling the fuck out here for a little bit. Maybe it calms me down and I decide to go back and get in the game. Because I want to put in hours, I just don't want to put in frustrated and distracted hours. It's an amazing 57 degrees out here. Feels fantastic. You know what? I am gonna do that. Let's grab a coffee. Let's do this. Just do it. You know what I did? I put a little sprinkle of cinnamon in my coffee. It's not something I normally do, but I'm thinking it might give me a little extra hint of wintry holiday spirit out here in this 57 degree beautiful ass weather. Oh yeah, that adds a little bit of spirit to the coffee. You know, it's like weird, whenever I'm in a poker game and I'm not playing my best and I'm distracted and I'm frustrated, I feel like there's this pressure, you know what I mean? And then when I leave the game, it's almost like the pressure is like going away. I don't think this is generally a good thing. This is definitely not a healthy snack, but you know what? Cranberry Bliss Bar, and it's just adding to my wintry holiday spirit out here. All right, I know you want to try it. Here, give it a shot. Oh yeah, you love it. You know what's a really good thing? The fact that I don't have a problem with gambling in the pits, because it would be days like today then I would run off into the pit and play blackjack. I'm just so glad that I don't have that problem, because that has absolutely killed a lot of people who come to Vegas to try to play poker or do anything else for that matter. I'm telling you right now, if you move to Vegas to play poker for a living and you can't stay out of the pits and you can't control alcohol, because alcohol is available to you 24/7. And if you're playing poker, it's free. So imagine that if you've never done it before. You can order drink after drink after drink after drink. They're free. Most people tip the waitresses. When I got up today, it was 64 degrees in my apartment. That was at 12:30 p.m. Not a big fan of turning the heat on. I bitch and whine all summer about the heat. So then when it gets cold outside, I want it to be cold. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, leave a comment down below. That's the fastest I've ever said that before. I'll see you next time.